And I'm back. Sorry about the pause. Real life stuff got in the way. Anywho, I hope it didn't interrupt Alan's speaking midway through that, but just in case it did, I'm actually going to let him talk about the page again. Just to be on the safe side.
The story I had written in the cabin had come true. Touched by the dark presence, I had written a horror story, but the end was still missing. The story was incomplete, and the last unfinished page of the manuscript still sat in the typewriter in the cabin study. If I could get back there, if I could read the page, then I could write my own entry of this story and save Alice.
I see. So that's what Alan has to do to figure out this whole situation. We have to get back to the cabin. The cabin, which, need I remind you, has apparently been missing since the 1960s, I think. And we have to write our ending. But we have a transformer yard to cross. Let's get over to this light. Because I need that checkpoint. I don't know what's over here. But we have to cross that bridge. Oh, it's one of those rotating ones? I see. I really ought to switch back to the pistol if we're going up against those minor enemies now. That's all the revolver ammo we can carry, apparently. We have a flare gun, and I'll take some more batteries and some flare gun ammo. As well as using that to rotate the bridge so we're able to cross it. Oh, great. It's rotating slowly. Agonizingly slowly. God damn it, why do you have to rotate so slowly? I mean, really. And that sound scared the crap out of me. I mean, I could be dead by the time it finishes rotating, knowing my luck. And wouldn't that just be spectacular? We get all this way only to get murdered by one of those things. Well, a bridge is rotating. And now it's going to keep rotating. Endlessly. Fucking endlessly. Oh, I thought they had been dealt with. Cross the bridge. I think we've done that now. And made it across. At least according to the map marker. There you are! Well, thank you so much for that, Sheriff. I am so glad you're here, and I'm not doing this by myself. That, and unlike the last guy who was apparently giving me support, the words are in air quotations here, you're not doing it. You're not doing it while trying to blackmail me for a manuscript and being a terrible shot and ignoring the guy who's wailing on me. Which I very much appreciate. And the fact that your support is actual support, I mean. So, thank you for that. And I hope you stick with me for a decent amount of time. Please stop it. And you didn't, and we're dead. Lovely. Great. Dead again. As I like to say, if at first you die, then die again. Because that fits the way my games tend to play out. Lots of death, and I will eventually barely succeed. That just seems to be how things happen when it comes to me. Not sure why. They just happen that way. But we are running low on shotgun ammo. And I don't even appear to have a full clip worth of shotgun ammo, if you can even use the term clip to refer to a shotgun. Okay, and they have to bugger off at the moment, so we're not really in a position to be receiving continuous help from the sheriff and Barry up in the helicopter. Oh well, I always kind of suspected that would happen, because continuous support would not have been enough of a crap your pants, your fuck type situation. Now, cut it out. I said, cut it out! Oh, and while you're at it, please go fuck yourself. I'm going for a flare gun now. We need to get past those guys nice and quick. And a flare gun will do the job, I think. Not right away, maybe take the first couple with the revolver. Actually, fuck that. Get a bit of distance. Flare gun, motherfuckers. Flare gun. Down they go. Alright. reloading the flare gun. For we need it again, as we will. There really isn't anything to talk about. We're gonna need it.
Painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Okay. Go to the power plant. And in we go.
Cynthia, I'm a friend.
Prove it!
You knew Zane. Thomas Zane. You're the Lady of the Light in the song. You can help me.
I think she's been convinced.
Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you.
She looks different. Or is this a different person?
Excuse me?
What you'll need to drive the darkness back. The rooms at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Okay, first let me look for supplies.
Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
Okay, just let me finish picking up what supplies I can carry.
We won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking rules, young man, and where has that gotten us, hmm? Oh, I have a secret route.
Well, I have to say, that's a very smart rule number one to have.
Something was
but, we are going to need to break it, probably, is the feeling I am getting.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules.
It's necessary, lady.
Kill switches outside.
Okay. Now, what do I do? Okay. Cut the power to the transformer yard. Flare, flare. Flares, flares, and plenty of bullets to shoot.
Edward sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her.
Yeah.
I hoped Weaver was.
She seems like
I stumbled into this crazy
kind of, well, arrogant and bitchy, and I don't really like her, but if she's willing to help us out and get us what we need to stop this crap and get Alice back, then I am willing to put up with her. As much as I really hate her.
Cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it.
Yes, indeedy. And puzzle, lovely. Floodgate
if
controls.
I could figure out the gates, I could use them to get to the kill switch.
I doubt it's all that simple, but we're closer. We can get over to here with that, so that's nice. The first one. And the second one. Okay. Those. Let's see. Do we have it? Or. Probably not, but. I want to try what we've got so far and see. At the very least, we should be close. we got here. Excellent. Now, cut the power. Balls. And I'm stuck now.
The transformer yard went dark and dead. Weaver's water pipe passage should now be good to go.
There we go. Checkpoint, and what's gonna try to kill us on the way back, I wonder. Did I even need to ask? I mean, I knew it would happen, just not the how. I just didn't know the little details. Please die. Now, reload as much as you can in the shotgun. And they're doing this again. Silly darkness. Haven't you learned anything by now? Putting inanimate objects in the way only pisses me off. Flashbang them, I think. Reload your gun, Alan, and take him down. Open. And use that thing. Reload the gun. I mean, we're running a little low on ammunition right now. But we're better off than we were last time. Hello there, lady. What do you have to say now?
This way, young man. Follow me. The pipe's empty now. We're ready to go.
I'm going heavy duty, I think. Much more useful, at least in my experience.
I knew them both, Tom and Barbara. Had such a crush on him. Such a beautiful man. I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident.
Wait,
and then
what?
Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring him back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
Yeah.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. Which looked like her. But it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until he was too late.
This story sounds eerily familiar to the one we're going through right now. I wonder, is it possible that Thomas Zane is an alternate reality version of us? I mean, I don't think so. That would seem to be just a little bit too cliched for this kind of story. But who knows, really? And we're switching to the hunting rifle because we are running low on sniper rifle ammunition.
Darkness isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own dark ends.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me in television.
Television? It's been us on the television. Wait, what?
He saved us both. Darkness stays with you. You sustain. This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going. Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
It's Sarah now?
Whoa! No! Sweet love of...
Barry! Barry! We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Yeah, to hell with you, lady. We're going after Barry.
Well,
or at least going to see if they're okay.
I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
Yeah, caution be damned. We're going after Barry. I don't care what you think, lady.
At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
And apparently we don't, is what she seems to be saying. Not that I'm really inclined to care what she thinks. The falling helicopter.
Sarah was almost starting to relax. Maybe they could turn this into a win yet. Suddenly, there was a piercing sound, like a table saw gone wild, as 100 birds made out of shadows swarmed into the rotor. The chopper bucked wildly and the board lit up, telling her what she already knew. They were going down. Barry Wheeler screamed next to her.
Okay, so they crashed. We already knew that, but interesting confirmation and all that. Now, though, we gotta get to our destination, and these things are plainly not going to make it easy. So we'll probably have to fight them as we go. Well, fight being a very loose term, since that involves basically pointing our lantern at them. Not that that makes it really any easier, because they've already killed me multiple times. And I imagine the same thing's gonna happen at least a few more before we hit the end of the game.
As far as I could tell, the wreck
good,
was empty.
Good. Maybe they at least made it out. But now we have to find them. The well-lit room. So we know where we're going at the very least, and it happens to be in the same direction as where we're trying to go in the first place. Thank you. And these guys have all had their protection knocked away. So now we respond to them with a bit of aggressive negotiations.
Like Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid.
I have a different ending in mind.
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
I knew you'd be all right.
How's that?
Give me a sec, guys.
Laugh
somewhere nothing to loot in here. And now we're a party of three. Though I'm not sure how long that'll actually last.
Running uphill, while the crazy bunch of demon hicks try to take your head off with an axe. You know your helicopter crash landed in Night Spring.
Not now, Barry. This really is not the time.
But now we're safe in the light.
Great.
You see those lights? That's the elevator we need to take.
Okay. Which means we've still got a bit of a trek ahead of us. And more of this crap.
What the hell is that thing? It's everywhere! Oh crap, there's more than one of them!
Nothing moves like that, it's impossible!
Apparently possible in this case.
Al! Do something!
Okay, we'll fight them. They turn up, but for now. For now.
Wait, this is bad. This is really bad.
Yeah, that's pretty much the understatement of the damn century, Sheriff. And I say we keep on going and fight them if we have to. Because since they're moving so fast that it's this difficult to hit them when they're shadows, it also means I can't get a light on them to make them vulnerable
that
easily.
That was... wow.
Yeah, and we're only safe for now.
Wait, call the elevator. I'm keeping...